This was one of the matching ones. So in order to do this one by itself, we should know which graph we're looking for, what it looks like. If we've been really keeping up pace and everything's been clicking with us, we might recognize that this tells us what about the graph. So what is
the slope's one?
Y intercept is one.
And the slope is negative 2/3.
What does that mean?
That it goes over 2 and down 3.
Goes over 3 and down 2. Down 1, 2. So over 3 and down 2.
So you have to do the Y. So 3 would be pretty much the over. What if you went over 3 down 2? That only went down 1 screw.
I went down 2 from the previous point.
Oh!
Over 3 and down 1, 2. So you had a negative 1.
Oh.
Now,
I see.
I like that shortcut, but if you're forgetting the shortcut, you need to go back to basics. Every time you do the shortcut wrong, you need to go back to basics. Okay, here's basics. The basics of what is a graph made of?
Points.
Yes. And how do we find those points?
We graph them.
Then we have to
solve an equation.
Okay, we're getting there.
Plug
in
x.
Plug in x, right, and find the y. That's what a point is. It's a place in the plane somewhere, and we know where it is by its x and y. Okay. So this is a really easy point to find. Why is it so easy to find?
You just plug in 0.
Exactly. You plug in 0 for x. 0 plugs in for x times negative 2/3, you get
1.
And we can see that every time our equation looks this way, this guy will always wind up here next to 0 for x. 0 for x always gives us whatever this number is. As long as the equation's written this way. If it's not written this way, it doesn't work. But if it looks like y equals a number times x plus b, then plugging in 0 for x makes this term go away and we're just left with whatever b is.
Wait, so
without doing that?
Without doing this?
Yeah. Like, how do you graph it without doing that?
Just kind of like practice and repetition and noticing that pattern and then saying, you know, like, you never do that. Maybe, like, just maybe in your head you do that and you say, I know if I plug in 0, I'm going to get 1. So I'm just going to put a point right there at 0, 1. See what I'm saying? So it's just kind of, it comes out of habit, it comes out of practice, a little bit of memory, okay? But you should always be able to explain why there's a point there, and it's just because when I plug in 0 for x, I get 1 for y. I can see that just by looking at it. I can see when 0 goes in for x, I get 1.
What happens if you always, what happens if you put in 3?
Exactly, what happens when you put in 3?
I mean
2.
I mean, oh, I see. So you could just put the x plus the 1, and that gets you 3. Then that puts the answer right there.
X plus 1 gives you 3?
Yeah. No, if you put in 2 for x, alright, plus 1, you wouldn't even have to do the math. You could just do 2 plus 1 equals 3, and then you go over 3, you go down.
We've almost got it, except for that happens, kind of happens when you plug in 3. Watch this.
That's what I meant.
You plug in 3, the 3's cancel each other, what are we left with?
2 over 1.
No.
Negative
2.
Nah.
Negative 2 plus
1.
Negative 1. Shoot. We could go over another 3. That would put us at 6. Let's see what happens there. Well, now the 3 cancels with the 6, but it doesn't leave a 1 like it did here. What does it leave?
2.
So now it's negative 2 times 2, and so it's negative 4, right? Which is 2 lower than we were before. Negative 4 plus 1, negative 3, right? Down 2. There we go to 9. I'm going to go down another 2. And I'm going to be down
5.
So up 3. Up 3. And every time y goes down by 2.
You mean down 2.
I mean up 3. Right? Adding 3 on. the previous x. So the x is increased by 3. Every time x increases by 3, y decreases by 2. So we have a negative slope. So it's like water is leaving the ridge, but like the container. There's a hole in it, water's going out, water's going down, the level of water is going down as time goes by.
It could be going down through the bridge, water going under the bridge.
I guess we work pretty hard, we can make that work.
Yeah.
So what was it? This is 11.
What did we do, guys? Something in there.
So we just discussed this. When your equation looks like this, there's your y-intercept, because you can see that's all that's going to be left. You plug in 0 for x. And right here, that is what?
Slope.
The slope of the graph.
The rate of change.
Slope of the line. Does this look like this?
Uh-huh.
Why does this not look like that? What looks different about this?
Because you would have to minus one on.
Perfect.
Minus
y
that.
Is not by itself. Now it is.
Now the y is negative one.
The y is negative one?
Yeah. The intercept.
Yes,
the
y-intercept is negative one. So the y-intercept is negative one. Or the point is 0, negative one.
Gosh.
And the slope is. Over 3, up 4. Slope is 4 times. Y equals 1/5 x plus 3. Graph and identify the x-intercept. Yes. Graph and find the x. So how do we graph it?
You do y would be 3, positive 3.
There would be a y-intercept at 3 because I know you like I just could do it so fast in my head. This is what I can do in my head. Plug in 0 for x and get what for y?
3.
There we go. That we know there's a point right there at 0 for x, 3 is what we get.
And then
for
you
y.
Can do 5/1.
And plug in 5/1, right?
Mm-hmm.
And if we do that, if we go over 5. Then we know we're going to go up 1 from here. Right? Go over 5, we're going to add on to 1. You can even do it yourself if you want to do the math there. 1/5 times 5/1 plus 3. Well, 1/5 times 5 is just 1, so that's what we're showing you. We just add 1 more on, go plus 3. And now we have a line, or we have 2 points to which to draw our. If you want to go like just over to 5 and up to 4, that's the actual point, but we're using the pattern of slope, which is every time I move over 5, like I start at a point, then move over 5 from there, I just move up 1 from that point.
Okay.
Then I move over 5 more, I go up 1 more. So it would be like you gain an inch of water every
second.
5 seconds. Every 5 seconds you gain. Now it says that it wants us to find the x-intercept. So to understand that, let's just quickly talk about the y-intercept. What's a y-intercept? Daniela?
The y-intercept is the y-axis,
right? It's a point, okay?
Mm-hmm.
It's a point. So for any graph, the y-intercept might be here or there or there or there or there. It depends on the equation, right? But no matter what, what do all points on the y-axis have in common?
They go through that.
They go up. They don't go through the the x because I write that I went through the y axis.
Oh.
So what do they? What do all these points? This point and this point and this point. What do all these points have in common?
They're all on the y axis.
Right. But those points being, you know, you can think of as coordinates.
Mm-hmm.
Those coordinates. What do all the coordinates have in common?
All the x's is zero.
All right. The x's are zero, no matter what. If I'm on the y-axis, the x part of the coordinate is zero
always.
So what can we say about x-intercepts, points on the x-axis?
Four.
What do you mean by four?
I mean it'd be five.
What do you mean by five?
Because, you know, from there.
The x-intercept is a point, just like Daniela said, that the y-intercept is where it crosses the y-axis, the x-intercept is where it crosses the x-axis.
So it's five.
So, nice.
Okay, so since you need to go down to the x the axis thing, you need to it's you go down one and then go by five and then keep going down by one and over by five and then once you get that it's -15.
Okay, you can follow that pattern all the way down. But I can also say that what's true about all the points on the x-axis, Hayden? On the y-axis, x is zero. On the y-axis, x is zero, and on the x-axis, y is zero. We're looking for some point. It's out that direction, and we're trying to figure out the x, but we know the y.
Oh,
zero.
I know.
Yeah.
Go ahead and substitute zero for y.
Yeah.
Zero in there for y, and then you go ahead and you solve for zero.
No, solve for y.
Four. X. I mean.
Right. Solve for variable. Solve for x. So, Clint, you're gonna solve for x.
Okay, so you can go ahead and -3.
Yeah.
So, and then you can go ahead and times by 5.
5. 5 times by 5 is 1. So we have 1x over here. Multiply this by 5. And just as Grace predicted, x is -15.
Ow. Because of what you just did. But, ow.
So, just about through it again.
Alright.
Points on the x-axis, all of them have an x, or sorry, on the y-axis, all have an x of 0, right? Because they're not left, they're not right, they're right in the middle. They're at 0.
You better take some notes.
I should have mentioned those out already. So, we're looking for the x-intercept. The thing that we know about the x-intercept, these points have an x, whatever it is, but the y is always 0. On this axis, y will always be 0. Here's -1, 0. +1, 0. +4, 0. +5, 0. They all have a y of 0. So we have this equation that relates y and x. Now we know that y is 0. Replace 0 for y. And it's all for x. We're finding the x value that gives us a y of 0. And when y is 0, we know we're on the x-axis. So we solve for 0, find that x is -15. You can also see it by what Grace said. If you go back this direction and follow the slope, you go down 1 and over 5. OK, now we're at -5. Now we go down another 1. Then we go back another 5. We're at -10. If we go down another 1 and we go left another 5, we'll be at -15. We'll be on the x-axis.
Oh,
so why don't we have to go over 5 every time you go down?
That's the slope. If we go this direction, every time we go over 5, we go up 1. If we go this direction, we go back 5, we go down 1.
Opposite.
So you go that way, yeah. Okay. And like both moves are opposite. Left down as opposed to the right.
Okay. And you go down to the x-axis before you stop.
If you're finding the x-intercept, then yeah.
Okay.
But you can also do it algebraically by saying, I know y has to be 0 if I'm going to point that on the x-axis. Mm-hmm. Solve for x.
So if you had went up to 4, you could do that 4 times, go down 1, and go over 5.
And the y-intercept is up here, then you have to do that 4 times.
Okay.
So if it's -1/5, then would you go up by 1 and right 5?
Yeah, if it was a -1/5, then our line would go this way.
Okay.
And you're right.
Okay.
But then again, to find an x-intercept, we can always set y equal to 0. I
yeah.
replace y with 0 and solve for x.
Couldn't you just take 3 times 5?
We did.
I mean,
negative 3 times 5.
Yeah, that's what I mean if you want to get at x.
Mm-hmm. Start to see it. I think that's exactly what we would do with this equation if we solve for x. Okay, that was number 18, and now
number 22.
26. 26. Elevator. Okay, the basement of a building is 40 feet below ground level. So here's the ground. Here's some building. And the basement is 40 feet down below the ground. The elevator rises at a rate of 5 feet per second, so the elevator goes up at 5 feet per second. And, okay, so you get in at the basement. You get in at the basement. So where are you?
40 feet under.
40 feet under. How do we express that just as a pure number?
Negative 40.
Negative 40, right? Because the ground level would be how high?
Zero.
Right, 40 feet above there. And we get all the way up to 0 feet. Right? 0 feet above the ground. We are negative 40 feet above the ground, right? Which means we're below the ground. Okay. So we start out at negative 40 feet. And then we're in the elevator, we're going up, right?
Mm-hmm.
So our height is getting bigger.
It's x.
Plus x?
Yeah, like 5x.
Well, 5x is different from x.
Yeah.
Well, 5 does 5 times x make sense?
Yeah.
Because
yeah.
it's 5 feet per second, and for x seconds, like if I go for 1 second, 5 times 1, I'll go up 5 floors.
Mm-hmm.
So 2 seconds. If I up 10 floors, it goes.
Mm-hmm.
So that equals, yeah, y. Where y is your height at any given moment. Sim, put that in phone jail, please. So the question is, write an equation, here we wrote an equation, and graph, and that's all. This wants us to graph it. So how are we going to graph this equation?
Yeah.
Put 0 for x, and then it.
Yeah. We can do this all in our heads, right? This is where that shortcutting comes in. Put in 0, we start down here at negative 40.
You could just divide 5x divided by 40, and then get 8.
That would make sense.
5x divided by 40 would be 8. I see what you're trying to say.
No, I mean divide by 5.
You're trying to. Well, okay. So what are you figuring out?
I don't know.
You do.
No. I think what I have.
You're figuring out how long it takes to
get up
to
zero.
To zero. To the basement level.
Yeah.
Up to the ground level.
Yeah. Eight.
Okay. So we can use that though. We can graph it that way. You have just found the x-intercept, right? You figured out what x it will take to get a y of 0, to get on the x-axis.
Mm-hmm.
The x-axis represents the ground level. So you're saying after 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 seconds, we'll be at the ground level.
Right.
So what you just did, without really doing it, is you said, let's assume we're at the ground level of 0 feet. And solve for x, right?
Boop.
So we added 40 to both sides, got 40 equals 5x. And what you did was divided 40 by 5, which you said was divide 5x by 40.
Yeah, I didn't mean to try to. You know what I meant.
Well, I know, but we have to be precise. So we got eight seconds it takes to get up to the top level. And now we have 2 points. That's all we need to graph a line.
What did you add 40?
What? Both sides?
Yeah, because you cross, you touch.
Solving for x here?
Because mm-hmm.
it's a negative 40?
Yeah.
40 to negative 40 to cancel
so
it out?
Why don't you just like do one side? that you need to say.
Why would I what?
Why would you do 5 seconds? Why would you just do like 1 second?
Didn't do 5 seconds.
Either 8 seconds.
Do 8 seconds. I found 8 seconds. I solved for 8 seconds because I started by saying that the height, let's say that the height is zero. Let's say we're at ground level. The question is how long will that take? It'll take 8 seconds. You could absolutely, instead of doing that, you could just say, like we already did, x is zero. We could just do, what about 1 second later? Where will we be? It'd be equal to 5 times 1 minus 40 is y equals negative 35. We go over 1 second, we put a point at negative 35, and go up there.
Okay.
And of course, if we did do that, we would wind up drawing a line right through that point at 8, 0 anyway.
Are you allowed to do, because I did a key for the problem, every line counts as 10 because there's way too much to, I wasn't going to write for the line.
Yeah, if I had some graph paper, I'd probably make each thing count for 10 or 5.
You could just do that normally. You could just be like 5, 10, 15, or 10.
This is 10. Go by 10s instead of 1.
Yeah. Oh my gosh. Sure, we don't be doing the x-axis on the test tomorrow.
You mean the x-axis?
Yeah, we're going to find the x-axis. Are we going to find it tomorrow?
No.
I don't know.
So you should be ready for it.
I'm ready for it, but I mean, we've only learned it a day.
It's the same exact process as finding the y-axis.
Yeah, but you got to do it wrong. Backward. It's kind of harder to explain. All right.
Or any equation.
Y equals 3/4 x plus.
If you want to find the y-intercept, there it is, because it's very easy to see what happens if I get 0 over x. Okay, so 0, 9. If I want to find the place where it crosses the x-axis, okay, on the x-axis, I know that all y's are equal to what?
To the y-axis.
On the x-axis, all the y values are 0. Just like on the x on the y-axis, x's are equal to 0. All the points on the y on the x-axis have a y of 0. So we let y be 0, right? We change y to 0 and solve for x. Subtract 9 from both sides. So negative 9 equals 3/4 x. How do we get x by itself?
By
3/4, I'm going to just multiply by 4/3, which is the same.
So would this practically be doing what we were doing earlier this year?
But
you
just solving for x, where we have to subtract something from both sides, multiply by the reciprocal.
But you just put 0 every time on the other side, the equal sign, because that's what we always need.
If what we're looking for is the x-intercept, yes.
Okay.
Go back.
-3, -3 times 4 is -12.
And that's your x.
And that is the x where the line crosses the x-axis.
Wait, I got a question. What would y be?
Y is 0.
Oh, yeah.
We made y be 0. That's how we figured out what x would be.
Yeah, that, sorry. That's what I thought. I just wanted to make sure. I just like to make sure.
Put everything away.
Gosh dang it. I'm not ready for this, but I am.
Alright. Well, this shouldn't take too long. We've had lots of practice here. This graph is fine. How's it gonna go?
You're welcome.
Kyler?
Well, you know, the slope of the y is given 2.
The
y-intercept is going to be 2.
Okay, so there's going to be a point up here.
And then you're going to go over 3 and up 4.
Over 3 and up 4. Over 1, 2, 3. And up 1, 2, 3. You can sit down, Kyler.
I did that backwards.
I think that's what I just did. I don't know.
Okay, now, if you're doing things like doing that backwards, And that is an example of where you should go back to basics and remind yourself of why we can just put a point right there, why we can just move over 3 and up 4. If you don't understand that, as we try to move forward, this is going to compound the confusion.
But wouldn't it be 6 though, because you have to add 2 to a 3? Oh, why?
It is 6.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Oh, I thought you said 4.
You go up 4 from
from the previous point.
Oh, from that, from this.
Okay, that's what I was confused. I'm sorry. Alright.
So if you always do 0 before, say 0 plus 2, that equals right there. And then if it is, like, say, a 3 up top, so 3, 4, so you can just go up 3 and over 4.
Yep, and you would go over 4 and 3 in that case.
Oh, okay, and does that work for any equation? Like, okay.
But you shouldn't need me to tell you that because we know that the first part, plugging 0 in, I think we're all getting the hang of that, that's obviously going to be the only thing that's left, okay? And the, like, how many I go over is determined by this denominator, right? Because I want to cancel the denominator with whatever x is. So x will be 3. That's the over part of the slope. I'm going to go over this much because it's at that x value where the denominator gets canceled out.
Okay.
And it'll just be 3 cancels with 3, and then you have 4 plus 2 is 6. Question?
What happens if
you get a lot of points taken off if you just put it as, you put it at 4, 3?
You'd probably get like 2 out of 5. Because what you're doing there is you are trying to skip over the understanding part. You gotta understand. Okay? When somebody puts a point at 4, 3, it tells me that they've been watching and they've been kind of soaking it up a little bit. Alright? And they're doing okay. They're working on it. They're getting better. But they've tried to skirt around the understanding part. Tried to memorize steps and then memorize them wrong, and if you memorize steps and you can make that kind of mistake, it shows you don't really know why we move over 3 and F4. Did you forget? If you feel like you're forgetting, you're just like making that kind of mistake over and over, go back to basics. Plug numbers in for X.
Ah, oh, that's what I forgot to do. Son of a Richard. I forgot to add 2 to it.